thought you could do that? Fucking what?
Did it. None of your business, how are you? And then it's a bunch of shite. I don't know what that noise was, but it was manly, wasn't it? A cheeky ham shank. Thank you for the follow. No, see, come on. Come on.
Come on.
Did he see that? He fucking seen it. The cherry is on the sundae. Repeat. The cherry is on the sundae.
Who is this?
Take an eagle. You know those eagle screams you hear on TV where they're like or whatever, or whatever fucking eagle noise. That's not an eagle. That's a red-tailed hawk. An eagle chirps like a goddamn nice. Pansy bird. Tweet, 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 tweet. That's a rough ninth there, Brad. I'm sorry about that.
How the devil are you?
Oh, that didn't work.
That didn't fucking work, did it? I don't like that. I don't like that at all. Paste me fucking... You're not pasting me fucking link. I'm trying to get people to come and stream. And you're not pasting me fucking link properly. Here we go, lad. There we go. Out devil eye and all that. What's that? Close that, close that. Clips were glitchy. Clips are gone. We're no longer caring about the clips. Let's delete that message. I am here. Yep, I've not left myself muted, which I briefly feared that I had. Let me know if anything's not working, because Windows updated, and when Windows updates, it fucks everything up. All my camera settings were reset. All my microphone settings were reset. OBS started acting up. Who knows? Tired because you didn't sleep enough. Well, guess what, buddy? High fucking five. You high five the monitor right now. Come on. Come on. High five it as hard as you can because I didn't sleep well either. But I have an excuse. I have a baby who wakes up repeatedly through the night. That's my excuse. What's yours? Tired. Last week, I had all of last week off, and it was glorious, and this week I'm back to work, and I'm very, very, very busy. Not because there's like stuff built up when it was off, like there was a couple of things to do when I got back. But Monday caught up, did a couple of things. Tuesday rattled out something that could have taken longer, but we're going to test it and see how it works. But today, everybody's been at me today. Everybody's here, look at this, here, look at that, here, look at this. And then I had to go to the dentist and they were like, hey, fuck you. And I was like, no, fuck you. And then I came home again and then I started looking at the laptop and they're like, hey, look at this, hey, look at that. I was like, no. I see a concert. What concert were you at? Who were you? Who were you vibing to? What else have I done in the past week? I completed God of War Ragnarok, which was the main story. Very, very good. I enjoyed this. Plot holes, but you know, suspension of disbelief and everything. Canon in fiber. Right, let's just have that. Can add that to the list to check afterwards. Okay, I put it into Google and it says it's an anonymous German melodic blackened death metal band. That's a long genre. Anonymous German melodic blackened death metal band. Is that? Infuse. A genre that infuses both black metal and death metal. Pot in a hole? What? Lou, I can't decipher this. What's going on? I played God of War Ragnarok. I wasn't talking about potholes. There was no pothole chat. What? Did I have a fucking episode where we talking about potholes and I've just come back to consciousness? I played God of War Ragnarok. I completed God of War Ragnarok. I very much enjoyed the story. There was plot holes and stuff, but I got past that. And then I played the Valhalla DLC, and it was fine. Obviously I went from like a fucking 50 hour plot holes, there you go Lou, plot holes. I played the Valhalla DLC and after like 50 hours on the main story mode doing all the wee bits and bobs and enjoying that, and then going to the DLC, it was really just fucking erectile dysfunction, the game. Hello, Nebula. Welcome in.
How the devil are you?
I'm grand, thank you. Tired. Very tired. But otherwise, fine. Otherwise, fine. I was sorely tempted not to stream again, but I keep doing it where I'll take, like, fucking Wednesday off, and I'm trying not to do that. Any potholes in God of War? Probably. Like, the game suffers from what I will call Raiden MGS2 syndrome. In that you start the game playing as Kratos, or, you know, in MGS2 you start as Snake, and then you get made to play as Raiden, and you're like, the fuck is this? I don't want to play Raiden, I want to be Snake. Well, there's a similar in God of War Ragnarok where you play as Atreus and you're like, I don't want to be fucking Atreus, I want to be the big man with the big axe. I don't want a bow, I want to chop things with a big axe. Ramping up the exams, well, very, very best luck for those. Off for a month over Christmas, off for a month, oh, the dream of being off for a month again. Ugh. Oh. With funding. Yeah, I did not try properly when I was a uni student, so I had a lot of time off. This is why I went back and finished it properly. With funding from the OPIG Corporation. World of Warcraft made me, well, I say made me, I failed my third year of uni because of World of Warcraft. And then I quit World of Warcraft because I realised I wasn't actually fucking doing anything in the game. I was logging in to run around in circles and see if anything was happening, and it wasn't. So then I disenchanted, reduced all my good gear to magical components, sent them off to my pals, got all my gold, sent it off to my pals, deleted every single character, deleted my account, never went back to it. And still failed the third year, and then went and got a job for a few years and went, this sucks, and so went back to uni. Used artifact parts to build an artifact. Well, that's... used something to build an artifact. I would say artifact parts to build an artifact, but that's maybe not true. Believing it could take hatred and then give empathy. Artifact might be wrong there. But it's the only really thing that fits in here. Something parts. They used something parts. What did they use something parts? You could actually put something parts in there. They would do nothing though. Artifact parts to build an artifact. However, it actually did nothing. Due to Tess and Avaris overspend, the Harmony Foundation building was repossessed. That's true. Tim Spender realised that the artifact might work if it were rebuilt. Marie Westlake was in charge of its reconstruction, but did nothing. Despite this, Eugene Marmot activated the new device, so was denied testing. That's clearly wrong. So... did nothing is maybe not right. Delayed testing. And was denied access. Access? Lab access. I worked in a hospital for ages doing a physio assistant job. It took 3 years to get into the physio course, and I now and eventually go back to the hospitals and get paid more for a similar job. You can get those Benjamins or Queen Elizabeth's, Prince Charles, get some cash. I went back and did the exact same course. Delicious euros. Colourful colour for money. Scottish money's better than English money. Just because it's got more interesting stuff on it. We've got otters and stuff. And Robert the Bruce and... colours. With funding from the OPEG Corporation, Tess and Avari ran the Harmony Foundation. That's true. They used... maybe that's artifact parts wrong to build an artifact, so... artifact parts, process, procedure, library, funding, overspent, enlightenment, discovery, stolen, broken, lab access, testing, drinking, reconstruction... and Mel Gibson from Braveheart fame. I don't think we have William Wallace on our money. Do we? We might. Murder, theft, hatred, empathy, heat, mass, chaos, order, life, death, something, nothing. Forgive me, I just choked on a hello. Hello, Law, welcome in.
How the devil are you?
How the fuck did I just choke on a hello? Oh, I'm okay. However, it actually did nothing. To reach enlightenment, however, it actually did nothing. Due to Tess and Avaris overspending, the Harmony Foundation building was repossessed. Tim Spender realised the artifact might work if it were rebuilt. Maybe rebuilt is wrong? Marie Westlake was in charge of its reconstruction, that's right. But delayed testing, despite this Eugene activated device, so was denied lab access. That's right. Eugene Marmot did that, and he did activate the right term there, and was denied lab access. That's correct. Marie Westlake's correct, and she was in charge of reconstruction, but delayed testing is maybe... No, that delayed testing's correct. Delayed... It's not delayed testing. Tim Spender realised the artifact might work if it were rebuilt. That's right. Due to this and various overspending, the Harmony Foundation was repossessed. That's correct. With funding from the OPEC Corporation. That's correct. Tess and Avari ran the Harmony Foundation. That's correct. They used artifact parts to rebuild an artifact. That doesn't seem right to me. Believing it could take hatred and give empathy. How the devil are we, Law? And welcome in. I hope we're all grand. I hope we've had a lovely, lovely week. I went out on Saturday and we got baby shoes, a baby's first pair of proper shoes. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you, come close, come here. Come on. They cost 58 fucking pounds for baby shoes. Fuck off. No, they weren't branded. There's no brand on them. They're proper shoes, like with a proper sole and everything. Up until now, he's had like soft-soled things just to walk around on floors, not outside, things like that. These are proper soled shoes. And we went in and we got measured for shoes. And was like, I've got this pair. And he's like, oh, how much are they? Expecting 20, 30 quid. Fucking near 60 quid for a pair of fucking baby shoes. We'll be wearing bin bags from the one. Get to Asda. See, I have, personally, bad experience of ever wearing any shoes from a supermarket or any place that's not a fucking shoe shop. They have shooed the fuck out of my feet. Welcome in, brew. How the devil are we? I once went to a job interview and I got the bus and I had to walk a wee bit afterwards. And I got these new shoes that I got on Asda at the last fucking minute. And I walked and it was a mistake because I got there and my feet hurt when I got there. When I walked back up to get the bus, my feet were in tatters and those shoes were thrown the fuck away. We'll get something better from like Next or something. I'm gonna have to let's go through the scenarios, right? Packing your bags. Jim Horney. One on Christmas Day, and I've spent a lot. Last year, we spent a lot. He was only 6 months, and we spent a lot. This is a slightly more modern setting, so it's like 70s, 60s, judging by the you know the color palette of the trousers. And hippies are in there as well. I think I've still managed to avoid the child section of Primark. I went online last year and just bought loads of clothes for him. In like 20 minutes, I spent 200 quid. We went over the top for his birthday as well. We had a big family barbecue. He didn't remember a damn thing. But baby clothes are very cute. Emotion studies. Oriel Toussaint. Maybe that's the wrong way. Oriel Toussaint. Oriel Toussaint. Realized. Oh ho ho. See, I did see recently some supermarket or branded place were selling baby Nirvana, Metallica, Pearl Jam band tees, and I'm like, really? That's 30 fucking years ago. This baby's never heard Nirvana. You got the Nirvana. If I ever see your niece, your 1 year old niece, I'm gonna push them over and call them a poser. You've never heard Nirvana, baby. You weren't there! With funding from the... Pink Floyd can fuck off. Ugh. Musical equivalent of listening to somebody have a wank. With funding from the OPIC Corporation, Tessa Navari. Times when you watched Supermarket Sweep and thought people were morons for putting nappies and other shit in the trolley, the other day, a big tub of fuck, just fill the trolley with Sudocreme. Or fucking Bongella. Bongella's $5 a tub. Tub, tube. The funding from the OPIC Corporation, Tessa Navari ran the Harmony Foundation to use artifacts to build an artifact. You would use artifact parts to build an artifact. There's no alternative for that. Please feel free to backseat, by the way. I think I got all the names correct. Unless Jack Nowak is... No, that's wrong. So, Marie Westlake. Yes, teething. You get two different kinds of Bongella. There's baby Bongella, which is for teething, and you get adult Bongella, which is for your teeth are fucked, this'll numb your mouth. Activated the device? Yeah, activate is correct. Whiskey and spring onions. I've never heard the spring and onions option. I do understand the whiskey option. I don't think I'd get away with giving the baby whiskey. Besides, that's my whiskey. It's for me. Anti-inflammatory. Well, time to make a stir fry and get the spring onions out. With funding from the OPIG Corporation, Tess Navari ran the Harmony Foundation. He used artifacts to parts to build an artifact. Oh, that could be... Parts. Artifact. Parts. To build an artifact. To build a procedure. It's and it's got to be an artifact. Yep. Believe me, it could take parts. I've written parts there instead of... I said I've written. Take hatred. And give empathy. Before Opik backed up by hired goons to kick everyone, the fellow got heavy-handed. Officials of hatred, blah blah blah. That's Eugene doing the thing. That's the call. That's that. The last four is correct, I think. I think this is correct, unless that's Aurel Toussaint as well. No. Oh, Marie. I think only one word is wrong. So no idol in there, so it's artifact parts, protests and borders, funding, overspending, enlightenment, discovery. I could use a hint, but none of these actually cater to the fucking puzzle we're solving. Take hatred and give order. Nope. Take hatred and give empathy. Reach enlightenment. You could only really give enlightenment. Nope. Reach enlightenment. However, it actually did nothing. It did. Did nothing. Did nothing's correct. Overspending. Funding. Nope. Discovery. Overspending. Repossessed is the only word. It works there. It might work if it rebuilt. Might work is the only word there. Rebuilt is the only word there. Right, I'm fucking stumped. Okay. Wrong window. That's the right window. Stolen. Sorry, I could have sat there all day and not fucking even considered changing it. What? I was learning about the Opig Corporation. What? However, it was actually set to heat, which started a fire. Give heat during a board inspection. Eugene Marmot actually set it to heat. It would be heat there. Give heat. Give fire. Which started the fire. Give heat, give heat, give heat, not. Somebody was impressed, yep, by Eugene Marmot. And rewarded him with a promotion. That's definitely right. Where is the go away hierarchy? This is the board president, who is name I forgot. Nathan Hoyle. Somebody Hoyle. I think it's Hoyle. Nathan Hoyle. Nathan Hoyle was impressed by Eugene Marmot's testing. Jack Nowak believed he had been no, Harmony Foundation. Tim Spender believed he had been punished? Because the something had been set to something something. The rebuilt artifact had been set to, I'm gonna have to go into here and have a look at it, see what it was set to. Oh, I don't remember this. So I think the symbols, that means give, that means take, that means fire, and that means cool, maybe? Take fire. Okay. If we go back to the lab. Nope. Go to the machine. Well, I mean, to take heat, which is why it was, however, it was actually started, which after learning about the OPIG Corporation, Jack Nowak. It has to be Jack Nowak because he was actually working on it. Believed he had been punished. That's not right. Believed he... Maybe it is right. Try to set it to take... heat. Okay, that's obviously... give. But actually set it to give heat, which started a fire. Nathan Hall was impressed. Usually testing and rewarded him with a promotion. Okay, it could be Tim Spender here, but I'm not sure. Definitely Mr. Hoyle there. Oriel Toussaint. Maybe Oriel Toussaint. I hate this. This has never been overtly hinted at, I don't think. Maybe I'm wrong. Fiery passion. This one might mean. Punished is wrong. Anything else? What else did I do? I've just been fucking working. Working sick. Oh, I've got a slow puncture in my car as well. Which is fantastic. Having to go out and re-pump that up every two fucking days. We were going out on Sunday and went out just to get the car ready because it was freezing. And, oh no, flat tire. Fuck you, buddy. You're not going anywhere. So after we bought shoes, we went and bought cakes.
And a lovely M&S meal.
Because it was nearby. Not because I shop it with any frequency in M&S.
Excuse me, sorry. Okay, why would you...
No, Harmony Foundation. Oil to Solent believed that he had been... something. No. No, no, no. Tim Spender believed he had been... rewarded? No. Because the device had been set to take hatred. Hatred. Because there's something, something. Because the... had been set to... let's take... I think hatred. Something artifact? The activated artifact? However, it was actually set to take heat. It was take heat. Which started a fire. It didn't start a fire. I'm confused. I'm tempted to look this up as well because this is kind of annoying. Okay. I'm way off. Give hatred. This is not at all obvious for, in my opinion. Where is it? Wrong one. A rebuilt artifact had been set to give hatred, however, it was actually set to take heat. Which throws a birdbath. Take hatred. Actually set it to give heat, which started a fire. Nathan Hollow was impressed by Eugene Marmot's discovery. And awarded him, okay, Harmony Foundation. That's not fucking obvious. I don't care. Fuck you. I looked up the solution because I'm getting tired. And that's what we'll be doing with the IDOL next. It's going to cause all sorts of legal problems. It's totally unscientific. Where's our control group? Sounds good to me. I'm sure the universe will guide us. Excellent. Full steam ahead then. Is Nathan going to... not Nathan. Yeah, Eugene going to be murdered next, perhaps. Welcome to the penultimate part, Chapter 4. The Trials, in which mind-bending discoveries are made. Feathered Frenzy, a deadly attack at the aviary. What's your favourite bird? Do you have a selection of favourite birds? I like a crow. Your standard crow. Discovered a bird. Discovered a bird. Discovered a bird. Rot. Discovered a bird. Bracelet. Some shite on a shoe. Some eggs in a bush. Incubator Avery. The man is not breathing and his neck is bleeding. Discovered a bird. The death rattle uses its coloured feathers as something against predators, often mimics the sounds and silences advised. These nithilicks these creatures with their scavenged silences required, these creatures provoking self-defense. The red-breasted, this heron is known for its aggressive nature, extremely sharp. This bug-eyed yellow-footed, despite its extreme territorial bushes. Heron, bright plumage and feeds on live prey, has teeth. Grouse bird is endangered predator status, hides its eggs in. Incubator. Overexposure to heat from the incubator could prove fatal. Always remember to check on eggs after putting them inside. Why, he promised to take care of you, Avery. Incubator, the bird is dead. Poor wee bird. The bulb is hot to the touch. It is 20-1. Lori, a method of intimidation, a prey, its piercing cries, words as it's recently heard, as speaking will cause birds to scream. We're discovered in the jungle for loud bones, no loud noises, blah blah blah. Morag's Avery. More words there. Dead bird is a bit sad. It is sad, isn't it? All this flower piercer is known for it. Declan, what did you do? A wee bag of cocaine there. Bracelet. Eggy shoe. Crushed eggs. Dead lad. Bird. Is that everything? That can't be everything in this page, in this. A bird. That guy. Dead guy. Bird. I don't know. Bird. I'm sorry. Bracelet. Bird. Oh, no, there's more here. Cool. Lori, heron, grouse, hatchling, flower piercer, grouse, herald. Thanks again for running the incubation station for me, Declan. See you after lunch, Marcy. Daily notes, new employee starts, safety and handling training, 3 p.m. Declan, lunch break, 12 to 1:15. An hour and 15 for lunch, that's pretty decent. Mirror. To the one who stole my heart. Which one's still? I reckon they're a heart stealer. Appointment 12:30, August 30th. Welcome to Morag, Avery, new employee guide. Travel guide, steps for training new employees. Millet, lorry. Sunflower seeds, flower piercer. Horn grouse. White bone meal, the herald. Right. Connect each bird to what agitated it. Eggs. Bringing anything new into his habit to prevent agitation. Grouse bird is endangered predator status, hides its eggs in bushes. So we're looking for a bit of paper that says bushes on it. masked grouse. Yeah, it's got a wee mask on. Bug-eyed, yellow-footed. Bird is endangered. Despite its predator status, extremely territorial, hides its eggs in bushes. Right, next one. What other bird is on that? The something heron, right? The red-breasted heron. This red, the heron is known for its bright plumage and feeds on and extreme aggressive nature. Feeds live prey, has extremely sharp teeth. That'll be this guy. What agitated you, buddy? You're not on this list, so nobody gives a fuck. The death rattle. The death rattle lorry? It must be that. Uses colour feathers as a method of intimidation against predators and prey. Its piercing cries often mimic the sounds and words it recently heard. Silence is advised, as speaking will cause these birds to scream. Nithilix Herald. These terrifying creatures were discovered in the jungle while they scavenge for bones. Silence is required, as loud noises will set off these creatures, provoking an attack at their self-defense mechanism. There we go. This guy stood on the eggs and that fucked off that bird. This bird took his bracelet and stabbed him in the neck. The stabbing in the neck agitated this bird, and this bird that mimicked his getting stabbed in the neck agitated this bird. Hello, danger. Welcome in.
How the devil are you?
This is the mask, the blue titted fuckface. The masked grouse. And this motherfucker is the red-breasted heron. Is it over? Yes, it's all to do with the golden idol. So if we go, we can do a recap. I'll do a recap. I'm not sure how this is linked yet. This is all about the red curse and stuff. We don't know how this is linked yet, but that's the first one. And then two is about fucking get in here. Two is basically about this lady here and how she gets the golden idol artifact parts to rebuild it. This is about how the golden idol is taken away from her. You know what, we'll do a better recap. We're going back. Let's go back, folks. Right, so in the very beginning, there's this mustache guy. He did something. We don't know. He strangled the guy to get out. These folks found a dead academic, and we pushed together. He fell off there for unknown reasons. Then here, this guy got crushed by a pipe because these guys were fucking about. But in the pipe, dead guy. And you may notice he's got red eyes, right? In this conference, in the wrong fucking pit. This conference was going over the academic's death and was saying that the red-eyed guys were not related. How that's related to everything else yet, I don't know, right? This is about a guy escaping from prison. Left his wee jail cell. This lady buried somebody. Who did she bury? The man who escaped prison, we turned out. Turns out that man and her worked together to steal bits and bobs, like this crystal, to make the artifact. That's the guy in there. He's in here. And here she is, trying to buy artifact bits for this guy. But then, murder, most foul. This is the guy that escaped prison, and this is the lady wearing a big wig. And then in the next one, this is a lab where, we're discovering how did these guys get it? How did these guys get the artifact to set things on fire? This clown set himself on fire. How did they get it? Surely these hippies had something to do with it? I don't know. This you remember this because this guy was stroking his sausage. Straight jerking it, as they say. And here's the guys inside. He's also straight jerking it, but nobody can see. He's the crime voyeur. But it turns out they took the golden idol off the lady with the big hair. And she wasn't using it properly. She broke it. This doesn't work. This is fucked. And this guy stabbed him and got tased for it. And then for some reason we're in an aviary now. Yeah, there we go. The bleedy-eyed flower piercer. That's this motherfucker right here. I'm bleedy-eyed. How are we, Danger? I'm the devil, are we? What have we been up to? Where have you been? Who did you talk to? Tell us everything. Or don't. You don't have to tell us shit. Bleary-eyed flower piercer. Something herald. The masked. Nithilix herald. I think this is that one. The Nithilix herald. That makes you the something else. Something else. Something Lori. The Death Rattle Lori. Give very little support. Thank you for flying the Twitch flag in barren times. I have been on a Monday and a Tuesday, as in my viewing capacity, and I'm like, kind of wishing I could stream on a Monday, but pickings are be slim. There's some people on, and just like I'll leave them on in the background, but I'm not contributing. I have streamers I participate in where I don't contribute. I just sit and I'll watch them, and then other ones will sit in the chat, and I will be what's the word? A hindrance. That guy's called Declan. A nuisance. He's giving him, he's the new guy, so he's Declan Astor. That must be the woman who was in the other one, wasn't it? Yeah, that's her. That's Moore. Marcy? You're Marcy something. Crystal? Hey, Palmer.
Fuck you. Fuck off.
That's Moore. Her name is definitely Moore, okay? His name's Declan. We don't know her name. I've probably done the birds wrong. You are the masked grouse. You are the red-breasted heron. You are the bleary-eyed flower piercer. So you're either a lory, and you could be a herald. No, I'm pretty sure you're a herald. What the fuck? Yeah, uses colored feather as a method of his intimidation. Nithilix Herald. You're a Nithilix Herald. You're the... Are you? Whack. Something Lori. The death rattle Lori? Is that a thing?
I don't understand.
And then you are Declan Astor. You are Crystal. And you're Marcy something. I might be wrong. Marcy Palmer. Fucking yes. Eat my entire hoop. Right, at the Avery, Marcy Palmer. Cried when she discovered that a hatchling had overheated in the incubation station. Meanwhile, Declan Astor entered the Avery where his bracelet was stolen by bleary-eyed flower piercer. Following this encounter, Declan Astor went to feed. Okay, and there was white. What was it? Bone meal? Herald. Nithilix Herald. And... stepped on the eggs hidden in the bush. We need the filthy version of Golden Idol. Rise of the Golden Erection in retaliation. The fuck off. Where's the names gone? The Mask Grouse. Attacked. Dick Lannister. No, that's not right. The Bleary-Eyed Flower Piercer? Attacked Dick Lannister, killing him. His last screams were... they weren't discovered. They weren't overheated. His last screams were what? Mimicked by the Death Rake Lori, which agitated the Nithilix Herald, which then attacked Crystal Mir.
Fuck off!
User, says Idol. Nothing dull about this, haha, come on, let's be a vineyard.
Let's be a vineyard.
Welcoming Adamification.
How the devil are you?
I don't know why I said it like that. I can say it normally. Adamification.
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 Adamification. If you say that 7 times in a mirror, Adam comes in your house and calls you boyo. Which is really inconvenient for Adam because he spends a lot of time driving.
I bloody drive again, don't I? Boyo.
That's my flawless Welsh accent there.
Don't know why I agreed to this. It's bloody pain in my ass. Costing me a bloody fortune in petrol.
I've lost it. It's arguable as to whether or not I had it, but at the aviary, Marcy Palmer cried when she discovered that Hatchling had overheated in the incubation station. That's actually one of the better ones. Thank you. I will take that. It was probably fucking dog shit, but everybody else has been far worse by comparison. These people, I'm low. Like I'm almost at the bottom of the well, but these people have been digging at the bottom of the well. Meanwhile, Declan Astor entered the inferi where his bracelet was stolen by the Bleary-Eyed Flower Piercer, which is true. We've seen it. Seen it. This motherfucker right here. Following this encounter, Declan Astor went to feed the Nithilix Herald. I think that's right because he had bone meal on him. No, he didn't. What the fuck is this? It's green shit. What's green shit? Corn grouse. Must have been going to feed the grouse then. I think he had corn. Too many windows. Is that corn? Are we going to call that corn? They've got bone meal. He's got corn and you've got... I don't know what the fuck that is. Millet? What the black sunflower seeds? Or millet? I don't know what colour millet is. So we're going to see if he's going to feed the grouse, the mass grouse. And stepped on the eggs hidden in the bush. Oh ho ho. In retaliation, something attacked Declan Astor, killing him. Why on earth would the bleary-eyed double guy? Okay, I guess I did it. Hello, Ree, welcome in.
How the devil are you?
What timing, Ree? What timing? Just in time for the solve. Fuck you, Twitch, do the thing. You have solved the scenario. After volunteering in a trial during his lunch break, Declan Astor, a new employee at Morag Avery, forgot to take the hatchling out of the incubator. Then, while attempting to feed the musk grouse, he stepped on its nest. The grouse killed Declan, indirectly agitating all the other birds. I'm lovely, thank you. Wee bit tired, but otherwise, grand.
Research engineer, subject 37, did not arrive for his follow-up appointment. Another scoombag?
Another scoombag took the money and run. Scoombag?
That's possible. Either way, we'll need to throw out his research data, but what do we do with the data disk?
What's going on here? Backstage drama. Pandemonium at the Stardust Variety Hour. Athar have won fair and square. You don't like something, talk to Mitchell the producer. Order of contestants: Cameron Flake, Nola Rockow, Jamie Albright, Regina Littlemore, Vilmer Bellboy Prado, Athar Vreddy. I can't help but notice we are competing against a previous champion. We already know the judges like our act. She'll be a shooter for the grand prize unless something goes wrong. Shouldn't the rest of us get a fair shot, Cam? Right, she's raging. Gonna leather this guy. He doesn't give a fuck. There's a rabbit escaping here. The haircut's atrocious. This trumpet's got a life of its own. This guy's just in pure shock. This guy's hiding. Right, start with you. Whoa, you gotta chill. A bunny ran on stage during my act, but you don't see me whining. First the record, then a surprise act. This whole show is rigged. I performed a flawless waltz. Psst, Vilmar, could you tell the little dancer that I only switched my act because someone took my soda? Stardust, a wristband. How do we feel about woe versus woe? Oh, I have never considered this. I feel like I like the first one versus the second one. I'm an H at the end rather than H at the beginning. An empty cage. The balls, juggling balls. Trumpet, the musician. Props table, do not touch. I would have won if they hadn't put me as the first stinking act. All that worked, wasted. I thought he was a burpist. The fuck is a burpist? Lily Bell, sweetie, you show up that one act too late. I'll kill Vilmer for this. She could have broken his bones as well as his heart. La femme ennoyeuse. No weapons on set. I think it's a fairly good rule to have. Stardust Variety Hours, winner of yesteryears, 1969, 1970, 1971, 1972, 1973, 1974. There's been a sudden outpouring of complaints about allowing previous winners to compete in Stardust Variety Hour. We assure you that SVH is a fair contest with no possibility of skullduggery. What a great word that is. Continue to harp on will result in you being released from the show. Through your host, Dante Longo. M. Bergen's production team. M. Bergen. What do you do when you go into
Burger King, I'm Bergen. Jamie would have stolen the show if he could have used his knives. This is more good stuff for the blooper reel, though. General Rowe, the ventriloquist and magician each surprised me, but not in the way I expected. Funny clips of the reel. Lily was a no-show till the juggler's act. Record malfunction, sticky valves, ballerina freakout. Ballerina freakout is a great album name. Oh Lord, he Bergen. Original dance, meet Mr. Vlad, implausible forces, the pauper's waltz from La Femme en Noyes, Howlin' Wolf Blues, the remarkable Lily Bell. Right, I've missed some clicks. Got you. Got you. Look at that fist, just ready to punch fuck him. That. Click that, that's fine. Clicked everything here. Clicked everything here. Sweet biscuits, Cam, that's delicate. A small bite mark. A wolf tattoo. Lone. Wola? Lone Nola. Nola? Now we clicked everything. Oh, rankings. Oh, shit. I have not been paying attention. Hey, who won? Atharv. Right, Atharv won. Who the fuck is Atharv? I don't know. Oh, that's not even... I don't even know what the fuck... Who's who? You were the first act, so you're the... original dance? Fuck is... I'm confused.
I don't understand.
The burpist went... first? If they hadn't put me as the first thinking act, all that work wasted, I thought he was a burpist.
I don't understand, sweetest.
That's delicate. That must be Cam. You're Cam. Vilmer. You're Arthav. Because you're the winner, and you're the burpist, and you came first. Then who came second? Showed up one act too late, so the bunny showed up during his act, which is too late. You were before them. Mr. Vlad. You're second, you're Cam. Mr. Vlad the puppet there. Someone tried to end my life today. I've been a tad dramatic, but I was driving to the dentist and some fucking idiot tried to swerve into my lane at the last second. And I think I might be the first time I've ever used my horn in anger. Car horn in anger. We've used the other horn in anger plenty of times. and shouted at the window that he was a cunt. We were pulling up to a roundabout. And he just slowly fucking trying to edge his way into the fucking the lane without indicating, without looking, just decided he needed to be where I was. I'm not moving. Fuck you. They're marked, they went last. Final placements, meet Mr. Vlad. So Cam went, okay, I understand. The ventriloquist. Implausible forces, I don't know what that one is. Who's Lily Bell? Fourth was the ballerina. The magician? The musician? The juggler. Oh, there we go. Who was juggling? Would be great to see. Do you want to die today? I just imagined that as like a secretary for like are we looking to die today, or because I'm afraid we don't have any appointments until the new year. We do have a cancellation for tomorrow, however, so we could fit you in then. Do you have the paperwork here? Breakfast is included, sir, but it is after the procedure, so I will eat it for you. You will be charged for that that service. If you do want to go without the breakfast, we do understand. Right. The ballerina was called something else. That's something. Okay, there we go. Names. So we know Arthav Reddy 1, and that's the guy hiding. When we were on our honeymoon, we were in Skye for most of the week, and we were coming home, and we didn't want to do like a massive drive, so we had a... I mean, it's not a massive drive, it's like 6 hours drive, but even still, you still want to do it. We had a stay over in Inverness on Loch Ness for the night, and we got bumped up to a nice fancy B&B from the place we were. But the only downside of that was that it pumped water from the loch into the room, and I was not drinking that because every time we flushed the toilet, it looked like somebody just pissed in it. Your name's Cam something. Anyway, in the morning, when we were drinking the coffee from the water from the lake that we didn't realise until we were on the road, and we went, fuck, we just fucking drank that loch. Sorry, I do apologise. I just wanted some pastries for breakfast. Like, what could you get? Yeah, I'll just get like a couple of croissants and pan of chocolates or something. It's like just a wee plate of mini pastries. Can you get anything? Can you want some porridge? Do you want some toast? No, I just want the pastries. And I was eating my pastries and drinking my coffee. He's like, are you sure that's all you want? Are you sure that's... Fuck off! Fuck off, I've had my pastries. I'm fine. Gonna drive up the road to this wee village anyway and go and get lunch at a lovely wee cafe that we remember from last time we were at Loch Ness. The wee cafe in Drum the Drocket. And we had a lovely log burning stove thing on and a great steak pie and chips. And then I wanted to go for a nap, but I couldn't. What's your name? Dante Longo. Marie was a fucking glorious drive as well. This guy. Vilmar, you are called Vilmar. And you must be called Lily. No, Lilybell is the rabbit. Lily's not, that's not Lily. Who's Jamie? He's the juggler. So he's Jamie. Jamie's something. And then, come back to this guy. Record Mask, Ballerina Freako. Her name is Nola, because she broke his heart. Come on, working shit out. What's your name? Your name is M. Bergen. M. Bergen. There's only one M, so you must be Mitchell Bergen. And there we go, we got some more names. So, Rockow. Cameron Flake. Vilmar Prado. Prado, Jamie Albright, and Regina, little more. At the talent show, the act of sabotage, the act of a previous, okay, there we go. Regina Littlemore by something. Scratch on this? Yeah, there's scratches on it. Scratching a record by using knives? No, puppet. Mr. Vlad. And Cameron Lake did it. Meanwhile, something from the something to the something in retaliation, something after the broadcast, believing the something show had been rigged, Regina Littlemore attacked fucking Dante Longo. Right, so they stole somebody's juice. Did anybody call it pop? Did anybody have a bottle of pop? Or a tin of pop? If so, I'm going to have to ask you to leave. Meanwhile, something. Well, bubbly wobbly drinky poo. That is preferable to calling it pop, to be honest, Adam. Bubbly wobbly drinky poo. Oil. We don't have that. It's Pepsi, okay?
Yeah, you don't want to Google that. There's going to come up with some dodgy sites that.
If you cremate your father and put him in a tin, does that make a tin of pop as well? You see where I'm going here? Meanwhile, somebody, something. Somebody stole something, so somebody's got... You stole somebody's juice. You've got sheet music. You've got an armband. You've got specs. You've got incandescent rage. You've got a black eye. You've got a shite beard. Right. A small bite mark. So this guy was up to something. You think he released a rabbit? Need to look at the rankings as well. What am I missing here? I am missing something and I don't understand. This guy had a rabbit on his act. This guy got bit by the rabbit. This one stole the juice from the first guy. There's nothing to indicate that anything was in the trumpet. Stole. No. Sabotaged. Something from the something. In the cage. Released Lily Bell. That was, what was his name? Wilmer Prado. I need to turn off Nightbot. I keep thinking it's a engagement to sabotage. Jamie Albright's. Yeah, Jamie Albright's. Jamie Albright's act in retaliation. Jamie Albright. Poured a soda into the trumpet? Have a half drunk soda. Where is the soda? Where would the soda be? Too early with the bang there. Bang there, danger. Too early. First off, they sabotaged. They did not sabotage.
by scratching a record using Mr. Vlad. Meanwhile, Vilmar Prado released Lilybell from the cage to sabotage Jamie Albright's act. In retaliation, Jamie Albright, nope, not Jamie Albright, Nola. No, to sabotage Nola's act, because Nola used to be dating them. In the Nola Rockow.
Fuck it, keep bang! Bang! And the dirt is gone.
There we go, but the bang is now correct. Due to their past relationship, Vilmar decided to spoil his ex-girlfriend's Nola's magic act by releasing a bunny from its cage. In retaliation, Nola stole Arthur's soda and poured it into Vilmar's trumpet. Because Arthur couldn't belch without his soda, he changed his act to a dance, which surprisingly won. Clock. GN identification of time frame settings for the unnamed device. The donut button round to 1 minute or 1 day, so basically 3 days, just say 1 month. No need to get so specific, Jack. Also, you haven't submitted the name yet. Quit stalling and get on that. More clues. Useless. Can you fuck off? Spiel dance. Arthur's winning act. Age 39. I'm gonna be 39 in a month. I can't decide if he looks rough for that or if I look rough for that. Wood door, key machine, spider fool, forbidden vampire, objects, creatures. Build beware, action word, shout, shut, give, steal, the spiel dance. Opposites of common words are carried by reversing the movements of the counterparts. For example, give, deal. In ancient Lemuria, philosophers postulated that various parts of the body has particular character attributes. Spiel dance reflected this belief. This hand shape, when held to any particular body, refer to the parts accompanying a tribute. Knowledge, obedience, evil, strength, curiosity, one ginormous testicle. The lower body stances, perhaps one of the most curious aspects of Lemurian spiral dance, was the relationship between some lower and upper body movements and its effect in establishing grammar. This opens the door to many interests. If one footstep provoked the plural word form book becomes books, book becomes the book. I know what I'm seeing, Uncle. How did this foreign fool learn an ancient spiel dance they take months to master? Fuck off. He does eyes first, right? We need to get the book open. Knowledge. Open. Forbidden. Door. Doors. Oh yeah, that when one leg's lifted, it means it's plural, so doors. Where? Beware, evil. Fool. Fools, he's got his leg up, that's plural again. Who? Steel. No, but stop. This. What the fuck is this? Key. Z.
Yes!
You have solved the scenario. Mammut. Mrs. De Silva recognized the distinctive movements of Lemurian spiral dance from her uncle's book and was bewildered by Atharv's knowledge of this ancient tradition. Now me do it. Fucking. I could not dance if I tried. Contains useless information, contains 37 memories. Let's have a look at his dance, and I will do as much of it sitting down as I can. There. Now I will bust it out at weddings.
Everybody, I know, shh, I just want to say huge congratulations to you two. You're meant for each other, and I'm gonna do a dance for you. Hit it. That was for you guys. That's my present to you.
Right. Top to bottom. What are you up to? Having a wee smoke? Well, Sabrina, you got dumped in and forgot where you hid the booze yesterday. What a bummer week. Morley's cigarettes. Anything else up here, Sabrina? No. Get rid of the cat or you're gone, SS. It's a whole threat, trust me. I saw what happened at the picnic. We don't need to worry about him anymore. How can you be sure? How does Sunny even know about Darcy? Hey, something. Maybe cat. Saturday, go to the picnic. Unless Sunny's going. Church, work, get set up new sewing machine, game night with B4, leave early for date with Kenneth. Kenneth, Bo told me about what you did on Saturday. You know who seemed better for a few days, but now he's back to his normal behaviour. I don't think the threatening will fix this. Regardless, I don't need you to protect me. Moving forward, I think I can handle my old problems. Maybe another night. How to speak and be heard, dire discussions. Quick, mom will be back any second. A bottle of wine. This is incredible, how did you find her stash? That fucking beak. Mom, 5'6", Jane, 15, 4'11". This is Mimi Westlake with OPEG. We received your call. I'm sorry, Miss Combs, but we cannot divulge the identities of other participants in our research study. Have a nice day. Whose memories are these? Threatened by another resident, afraid for their life. Will they follow through? Attended the picnic? Have I gone crazy? OPEG, blah, 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 blah. All these words you are also capable of reading. I've been unemployed for about 2 weeks now, and it's awful. I figured that writing in my diary to decompress couldn't hurt, but I have nothing else to say. This is so frustrating. No one wants to hire me because I'm a woman. An interviewer today told me I should be looking for a husband, not a job. Well, sir, how am I going to pay my rent? Sunny raises it nearly every month. I'd do any job, almost any. Constance offered to pay me for babysitting, but I can't stand her kid. The hunt continues. I enrolled in a research study today to help me get by financially. Oddly, I don't have to take any drugs. They just sat me down in front of a crystal contraption. It was the strangest experience, but at least they paid me up front. Hopefully, I can sleep off these odd side effects. I think I'm going crazy. I have memories circling around in my head that don't belong to me. I remember details about the apartment picnic, which I never attended. I remember being threatened with a gun. I remember feeling terrified, but none of this really happened. At least not for me. Am I insane? Do these memories belong to someone else? A life could be at stake. I need to figure this out. It's not like I have anything else to do. Patience, patience, patience. Stay out of here.
Stain out of here!
Great for blood, grass, and other tough stains. Ernest.
I'm walking here.
Winthrop Sawyer, Nakana, Osla, Combs, Knox, Bird, Wright, and Steenson. Combs. Participants needed. Absolutely everybody having a great time there. Sore finger. You're gonna be indecently trying, at least close your blinds. This is harassment. I heard a package that hasn't shown up yet. If it got delivered somewhere else by accident, please let me know. Has anybody ever had a package delivered to like a not an immediate neighbor and you go out and said, I think you got my package, and they went, no, I don't. I have no idea what you're talking about. What's a mess? Haha, I'm sorry I didn't have the time to cook a fancy dinner. It's really nice. I'm jealous that you and Lavona live so close to the ground. Pepper spray. Get him fucking sprayed. Protect and defend the security guard creed. Sad sack. Watch it. I think he's a prison guard. I might already be too late. Somebody dead in here? Kai, remember to take out the trash Tuesday evening. Don't make me do it again. It is 7:15. You know the two is related already from the beak. Man has a bullet wound in his temple. Do you think he's going to be okay? Everyone knows it's the world's better off without me. Goodbye. Chopsticks. Did you forget our agreement at the picnic, or do I need to go up there and remind you? Hello, sir, I'm calling Fremont Pound. We just wanted to let you inform you we do not forcibly empower people's pets, even if you are a landlord. Thank you and goodbye. Noodle House. Another bracelet. Deliver to Spencer Wright. That's how he knew you had a cat. Go outside, playtime, playtime, mommy, I want to play. Two teeth, that bairn cannot say that. With two teeth. Lies. You heard the loud boom half an hour ago, honey. That meant no playing outside tonight, and Mr. Sawyer will be here any minute. Apartment inspection is on Tuesday at 7:20. Pick up after your brat or get evicted. Fuck off. Fuck off, and then when you fucked off, fuck off again. Right, we didn't click everything. We've missed one thing, which is annoying because there's 40 odd things to click. What was it on the table? It was on the table. They're playing a weird game. This photo was taken by on something. This photo was taken by on something. Right. Ugh. Who is in here? don't know your name, but you live in... Excuse me, sorry. That's B4. He must be Ozolo. Somebody Ozolo on Saturday. This lady. Kenneth Ozolo. Where are you, Kenny? Leave early for a date with Kenneth. Maybe his name isn't Kenneth. Okay, that noise stopped, thankfully. Right, so you're the landlord. Your name's Sawyer something. Sonny Sawyer. I just love his portrait as he's just being dead. It wasn't taken by Kenneth, it was something as a Zolo. Cheyenne is this lady here. And that's been ripped off as well. Apartment B4 is somebody Spencer. You've all been keeping up and I expect you to be helping. You're the golden idol. I'm thinking after we finish with this game, that we won't, not that we'll be finished anytime soon. We'll be trying to play the forest again. The Sons of the Forest. I think. Your name is Kai. Fairly, what's his name? Jasper? Maybe he's not in here. Maybe this is just, maybe people of the Golden Idol universe have massive noses. His name's Ernest. Your name's Sabrina. And one of you is Spencer Wright. I'm gonna assume it's the blonde guy. Your name is Cheyenne. Cheyenne Bird. And you are fuck off. Right, and Steensen, so you're Steensen, and you are Knox, Sabrina Knox. Sawyer's there. You are Nakana. Who are you? Top Winthrop. Yep. Your name is Winthrop and Winthrop, and then we have a photo. Yep, of you are also a Winthrop. Mr. Sawyer's dead. Didn't worry about it. Chopsticks. No names in here. Except Kai, we know Kai's name. You don't have a name. I think you're Cheyenne Bird, and this was taken by what was his name? Sonny Sawyer. And it was taken on, what day was it taken on? Monday. And we'll just say Tuesday. Sunday. I had to be Sunday because she's not wearing that top today. And today's Monday, I think, according to her. Today's Tuesday, so it could have been Monday or Sunday. We'll just need the this guy's name, Azolo. Old Sweaty Betty. You're Lavona. Aha! Ha ha! Where are you? You're Lavona something. Miss Lavona Combs.
Looks like we got another mystery to solve, Scoob. Hey, Scooby-Doo! Shut your fucking pie hole! You piece of trash!
Right, what's your name? Your name is something Zolo. It's not fucking Issa. It could be. It's not. But it could be. Then I saw her on a day. What is your name? Kenneth? Oh, she's got a date with him. So she, it was in the fucking date. leave Kenneth as well. Yes. So, Monday. Tuesday. There we go. Right, so his name is Kenneth Azolo.
Big old Kenny.
And her name is Giant Bird, and that was taken by Sunny Sawyer.
Good evening, Mars.
How the devil are you? How the devil are you?
Chili.
You're far southern. I know words. I do know words. You are far more south than I, who is much more chilly than you. Ha ha ha.
I'm in the north. I'm more cold than you. That's how it works.
There was, there's a couple of things I just remembered that I wanted to talk about. First off was the,
you wouldn't have been long getting frostbite,
guy. I saw him in a TikTok, and he is just beard and hair now. Big beard and hair now. And I went a wee bit northern, Northern Irish there by accident. And he was talking about how he was basically dating 70-year-olds and he was engaged to be married to this 75-year-old and they passed away. And are you fucking kidding me? Absolute dog, yeah. He said, what was he said? It was something like,
you have heterosexuals and you have homosexuals. I'm something of a fucking geezer sexual or something like that. Something like old person. Geriatric sexual, something like that.
Basically, he's been in the nursing home picking up old folk. The whole parents thinking, you're not tired until you're a parent. When I wasn't a parent, I thought very much, very deeply, you could fuck off with that. I continue to think that. I am a parent. I am tired. Yes, I am tired. But I am also aware that I have been tired before without a child. I think you are a Nox as well. Hello, Preds. Welcome in. How the devil are you? the winter fuel payment. There'd be more than a few older ladies shacking up with the young lads for their money. For a bit of heat. The other thing that I've been meaning to say for ages. I mentioned way back when that I had a heart monitor on for a day. And a few weeks ago, I finally got the results of that. And I got told that I have an ectopic heartbeat, which is entirely harmless. It's just the occasional extra heartbeat. And in order to get rid of it, it's treatable if it was more annoying. It could cause worse symptoms. Mine's is fine. But the way to get rid of it is to give up coffee, anxiety, and stress. The three things you have as a parent. Yeah, I didn't know, it was like, I googled it and it was like, NHS, how to deal with it. Just give up anxiety and stress. Or, and coffee. Right, we need to go through the clues again. I don't know your name, child. Unless it's on the fridge or something. Sam is there. It'd be Sam. Is Sam an option? Sam is not an option. I tend to have one coffee a day, maybe two at a stretch if it's before noon and I'm feeling coffee. Jane, her name's Jane. If the previous evening's shenanigans with the baby has been too stressful, then I will tend to have a second caffeinated beverage. Attended a picnic, have I gone crazy? Not them, not them, not them.
Wee restless legs.
When you're too tired. Your fucking legs are about 6 foot long themselves. You'd be like flailing fucking noodle. Wacky flailing tube man. Combs. Who's Combs? You have Combs. Somebody's Lavona Combs. Okay. Name, buddy? Likes fishing. Recently been for noodles. Somebody called Bo? Somebody called Bo? When I go into the office, I always nip into the coffee shop first. Get myself a muffin and a cup of coffee. Right? Somebody at the picnic is called Bo. Her. The only one we don't have a name for. That's Spencer, that's Jane, that's Ernest, you're Bo now. So we're missing roommate, father, baby. Do we partake in a wee pastry if we're hitting a coffee shop? Or do we just get the coffee? They put my coffee order up 30 fucking pence! 30 pence! 30 fucking pence! You... What am I missing here? B4. There's these two guys, and they've got... How does Sunny even know Darcy? No, Darcy's a cat. Yeah, sorry, going back to the whole parent thing and being more tired or less tired than other people. Fuck off with that. I've read things about like parents saying things like, single people don't know what it is to be tired. I should be able to jump the queue in the coffee line because I have a child and I'm very tired. Fuck off. Parents, fuck off. Well, okay, well, that's... that's the end of the stream, folks. Thanks for coming, Trippy, Danger, Mars, everybody else. I'll be back, I guess. Welcome, Trippy. How are we?
How the devil are you?
And such. And Prads, sorry.
How the devil are you?
As well. We're naming folks. We're giving people names that we've determined from other places. What names have we got here? We've got Winthrop, Sawyer, Nakana, Oz, Zola, Azola, Wright and Steenson, Bird, Knox and Coles. Right, we've got the surnames. We've got surnames. Everybody's got a surname, right? That's fine. Ernest, staying out here. Knife. A fucking handlebar tash. No other clues in here, right? Goodbye. Combs, we know that's who that is. Memories, photo, fine. But this, Constance. Constance, her name is not Bo, it's Constance. Who the fuck is called Bo then? Bo? Are you Bo Steenson and you Spencer Wright? Can't stand her kid, that's fine. Hunt continues. Nope, okay. So there's a clue there. Picnic, Sunny, Kenneth, we know them ones. Kenneth and Bo, Sunny's called Bo. Who's got the blue cards up here? You're red, you're blue and yellow, so you, I think, are Bo. Yes, so, what it's kind of like Mad Libs with Columbo-esque crime solving. Maybe not Columbo-esque, so... this is a scenario you're prompted with, or this is a scenario you're prompted with. They're all part of an overarching story to do with the Golden Idol. You go through each person, each clicky thing, you get words and a wee snippet of the story. That Sabrina here got dumped because of those shocking eyebrows. And you'll get the words here. You've got names, noun, other things and other things. And then you have to do things like figure out who took these photos, based on the story prompts, who they are based on everything else, where they live. So, for example, we know they live there, he lives there, they live there, dead guy lives here, this guy and this guy live here, and this guy lives here, this person lives there, this person lives there, this person lives there, with that person, and these two live here. But we don't know any of their names. Like, I don't know who this guy's name is. Or the child's name. So we have to go back through and figure out what words we've learned. So Sawyer, we know who Sawyer is. Sawyer's a dead guy. We don't learn anything from this guy. We're trying to basically figure out how he died, so once we've solved every other thing else, we get to fill in the Mad Lib bit and say what happened and what these symbols may or may not mean. Sonny Kenneth, Kenneth Bow, Combs, Memories Photo, Constance. Okay, so the name's Constance, and you're Bo Steenson. All the surnames, we've got them. Combs is Laundry, nothing here. Spencer lives up there, so we know Spencer's one of these guys. Doesn't have a name. Already figured them out. Kai is the child in the other room, so we know who they are. This guy doesn't seem to have a name. So I'm confused as to who's who. Lisa and Cheyenne. Come on, that's not good. Right, Lavona we have. So your name is Issa and your name's Cheyenne. And the thing is, it never tells you what, if you've only got two incorrect, anything above two, it'll say incorrect. Anything at two or below, it'll always say two incorrect. So you can never tell if you've only got one or two wrong. So what I'm looking for is to see where the rest of the words came in. See where I got the rest of the names. So your name is Sabrina, so that's your name. No name there. Picnic threat threatened. Jane, been there, that's their name, we already got them. Diary again, we got Constance, we already know who they are. This guy doesn't have any clues. Patience and Ernest. Patience, Patience, Patience. Patience, that must be the child's name. Okay, I don't know how we got Issa. We'll go back through the clues and see how we got Issa. That was just pure luck. The fuck did we get Issa? Kai. No snope here, as far as have a peek at the window. Make sure you can't see out the window. No, no snope. We're in a kind of a geographical cul-de-sac, so we don't get snow a lot here. Where the fuck did we get Issa from? On, right, now we need to do the thing. On Saturday, at a picnic. Kenneth Ozola threatened to kill Sonny Sawyer. However, on Monday, Wait, what? Well, Dundee is Scotland's sunniest city. That they really leaned on that as an advertisement for the city a few years ago. They made sunglasses and everything.
Scotland's sunny city. It's amazing. Come and see Dundee.
Fucking nah. Pass. However, on Mondays, or I'm gonna say sunny lawyer forgot the picnic after attending a research study that Lavona Combs also attended and received the former's memories. On Tuesday morning, Sunny Sawyer took a photo of Cheyenne Bird, which provoked Kenneth Azula into shooting Sunny Sawyer. Oh, fuck off. He definitely took the photo, because that's... Maybe Sunny Sawyer shot Sunny Sawyer. No, that's incorrect. Well, it is Kenneth. Big old Kenny. According to this, Sunny Sawyer did take the picture. However, on Monday, Sunny Sawyer forgot the picnic. After attending a research study, Lavona Combs also attended and received the former's memories. On Tuesday morning, took a photo. On Saturday, a picnic. So Kenneth did threaten to kill Sunny. Monday, Sunny forgot the picnic after attending a research study. Did he attend the research study? Yes, he did. Lavona Combs, that was her name, I believe. Yes. Also attended and received the former's memories. Sunny Sawyer took a photo of Cheyenne Bird, which provoked into shooting Sunny Sawyer for the good of everyone in the building. So he faked his suicide. So, what have I done wrong then? Picnic's correct, Kenneth is correct, and Sunny's correct. Because if we go to Cheyenne's place, she has a note to Kenneth. And you know who is Sunny. And Sunny forgot the picnic after attending the research study. Lavona Combs also went there, attended, was... Took a photo, is took correct? It's not received, it's... Took. We're one away from this getting being right. Took a research study. Took a photo, took a picnic. Cheyenne Bird. Yep, she's the one with the the sewing machine. I think she lives opposite him because, yep, he's a scumbag. Yep. Did Kenneth shoot him though? Must have. So if there's only one wrong, it's going to be green or it's going to be blue. Unless it's not Cheyenne the photo was of. It is of Cheyenne. It did, Kenneth did kill him, so what have I done wrong here? Offered to kill him. Did threaten him to kill him on the day of. Unless he threatened to kill him. He had a knife in his blood. Okay, no. There's blood, the blood. Ernest did it. Ernest. Did Ernest do it? Ernest didn't do it. Fuck! Ernest is covered in tomato sauce. Ernest doesn't have blood on him, it's tomato sauce. I think it's blood, but actually, child tomato sauce. Any input? Anybody? Any suggestions? He didn't dump the picnic, he forgot her, he offered, received, stabbed, threatened, took. You can't stab the picnic. He did forget the picnic. And he did attend the research study. I think. No. We're not stupid. I did Google the solution earlier, and some of them are fucking stupid. Holmes also attended. She did because this is where she lives. She doesn't have these memories. Threatened by another resident, afraid have I gone crazy. Why? Something about photos, check lobby probably. Okay, it's not them, so it's there. Attended the picnic. Prayed for their life. They've got his memories. He took a photo which provoked Kenneth into shooting for the good of anyone. Okay. fuck's sake. At the picnic, Kenneth threatened. He didn't fucking stabbed to kill him, did he? Forgot the picnic, forgot the research study, and went to picnic. How can that be right? Dump the picnic. Okay, so we know forgot's correct. Forgot back. Received, threatened, so we know received is correct. We stabbed to kill, which is wrong, so we know what threatened is correct. Stabbed a foe, which is wrong, so we know took is correct. Fool overtook. Posted the took a picnic, wrong, so that's foe. The form is Monday, that's correct, that's in memories. Forgot the threat, that's a good. Thank you.
Audience participation. Whee!
Sunny Sawyer, the petty landlord of Hesper Towers, enjoyed making life difficult for his residents. Landlords, eh? Pricks. At a picnic, Kenneth Izzola threatened him with violence and Sunny submitted. However, OPEG's research study removed the memory of Kenneth's threat for Sunny's mind. No longer scared, Sunny took an invasive photo of Cheyenne Bird, Kenneth's romantic interest, which was the last straw. Lavona received Sunny Sawyer's memories, but was too late to save him from Kenneth's vengeance. Kenneth's Vengeance is a great band name. Subject number 35, age 39, M, black, 53, blah, blah. Now that testing is over, we've got to do the important part. Give the device a name. I say we call it something incredible so the upper management knows we're poised to change the world. Please don't oversell it, Eugene. At its core, it's an information dispatching obstacle lens. Idle it is then. What? The donut button, round to 1 minute. Right. Useless. Parental consent obtained. That's horrific. That is give, that's take. That must be memories. Right, so we have to go back in to this. Back into here and check his bracelet. But he had something take memories for a certain amount of time. That's a donut. Leave this one. Go back to this one. He has something for that amount of time. And he had an appointment at 12:30. And he had, oh shit. So I would guess this means 1 day. Back. Not that, this one. Oh, take, give. Take the memories for 1 day. Take 1 day of memories. So 3 days, 1 month. Back. Okay, now. Back. Oh shit, I just clicked the wrong one. Oh well. Unless it was the right one. No, it was the wrong one. The complex. Into his again. Go into the bracelet again. Transfers. So they got their memories. And maybe back to the main page. This what is this is kind of annoying, going back and forward and back and forward, right? Right. Gray, subject 39 37. Black hair female, 26. There's only one dark haired female, so you are subject 40. Grey hair no show, 51, so you're subject 39. Now, somebody had to get parental consent, so it must be them. Because there's no other. Parent there. This one's useless. We have to go through these again and see who had a square in them. You didn't have a square. Was there even one in here? No, there was one in here. He had a square. So he got a square, but who did he get it from? We know he's fairly short-arsed as well. He has dark hair. No, he's age 39. We know he's age 39 because it was on the thingy. So he's subject number 35. And useless was... off. A data disk. Now,
I'm mighty heat confused here.
They're the only one who needs parental consent. You got those ones. That's correct. What did you get that from? There's no indication that you should be getting anything from anybody. Fill in the subject for them. So they're blonde and young. They're subject 42. What colour is Declan's hair? Declan's hair is brown. He didn't come back for a follow-up. Hair none. Hair none at 5'11". He's got no hair. Wait a minute. Wait a fucking minute. This guy didn't have a bracelet on. Uh-huh. Hmm. Subject 37's memories. Who the fuck is Subject 37? But they didn't have fucking red hair. See? You went into... Fuck off. This. A data disk. And that data disk. Fuck off. We're so close. Right, you're wrong, so you are correct. Wrong, so you are correct. You're wrong, so you are correct. Two, 39, 36, 40, and 43, 42. Love you. That's wrong. So you. Two of these is incorrect. Two of these are incorrect. So, nope. That's correct. This one is incorrect. I really want that to be right. I really want the wee girl to have the fucking the bird's memory. This one's wrong. Right. Who is 30 years old with no hair? You. This one's wrong. This one's wrong. What have you got then? You're not a data disk. Could you have your own memories? No. Could you have your mother's memories? She could have her mother's memories. She's 36. Fuck off. She knew where her mother's booze was, you see? That's what I was going for. She forgot where the booze was, but she knows where the booze was. Unless she wasn't actually in the thing either. Wearing a bracelet? Yes, she is wearing a bracelet. There we go. So she was in one of these transfers. Was it the other way around, perhaps? No. That's wrong. So the data disk is here. But you were definitely involved in a transfer then, so how could this be incorrect? Just making sure I wasn't showing you my pits there. You're welcome. Fuck off with that. Fuck off. Give me this. Give me the fucking list back. Right. You lose a day. You lose 3 days. You lose a month. You lose a minute. Nobody's a minute, so we don't give a fuck. Give, take, memories. He said, we're taking memories. Taking the fuck out of memories. We don't know who's been given the memories. That's the issue. Unless we go back through every single fucking one of these assholes. Which we could do, to be fair. What? I've got like 5 minutes left to try this. Complex, quickly. Quickly, quickly. Right, you. Had that. What's the symbol? The take memory. So you had memories taken. You're definitely there. Are you? Can't be subject 42. Subject 36. Back to this. Definitely a taker. Were you 6'4"? Oh, you're not 20 fucking. You might be subject 43. No. Brown hair, female. Brown hair, female. 5'6", 6'4". You're not 22. You're 43. That's right. Blonde, subject 50. So what's wrong then? Fuck it. Quickly, quickly. Try to get this game completed, man. I got the number wrong. Not 43. 41. Alright then, Deadbeat, give me your best shot.
Oh, he's gone.
Is that all you've got? Pathetic. Well, look who it is. You got a problem, Hunter. Welcome to the last chapter. Chapter 5, the pinnacle in which terrible plans are set in motion. We'll have a quick skek at this. Beach trip, a seaside photo shoot goes horribly wrong. Erse! In the ambulance. Okay, Sinister. We will find out what goes on next time. There must be a way. I must run away into the woods. Bear with me, we're gonna raid somebody, and then we'll thank you all for coming in, and I will see you all again on Friday. With all the words just disappeared from my head there. Just having a look and see who's on. No, Mars, no danger. Thank you for coming in today, this evening. Sometimes, right, we watch Danger raiding, or we watch somebody raiding. If Danger raids, he tends to raid an Irish streamer. That's allowed. And generally, as a rule, I think you can guess that they're going to be full beans. But when I look through the Scottish streamers, I'm like, are you cool? Are you going to be nice? Are you going to be not an arsehole? Plus, I follow all the cool Scottish streamers as it is, so if I don't follow them, there must be scum. They must be scum. They have to be Dodge. I'm just gonna read Togi. Spell that right. I spell that right. Thank you very much for popping in, folks. Thank you very much for the follows, unfollows, chat, redemptions, bits, tips, all the help for the help as well. All that good stuff. Have yourself a wonderful week. I will be back on Friday. We'll finish this game. And I will smell you later. Choo, and say hi to Toki, who's playing Persona 5.